Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to my workshop. This week, we're going to work on replacing the counterweight on the Dyna Myte 2800. All right, so in last week's introduction, I mentioned something about the Y-axis backlash being a problem, and I looked into it, and I'm not sure it is a problem now, so we're going to pass on that until we actually have some motors hooked up. It'll be a whole lot easier to work with once we have some electric to it and we can move the motors and do some real testing. So I moved on to a different project. As I also mentioned, one of the problems with this machine is it's missing some pieces. It's missing a lot of guarding, but the main thing that it's missing that's most important is it's missing its Z-axis counterweight entirely. There's no counterweight, the chains are gone, and all the mounting points are gone. Now, the pulleys are in place that the chains are supposed to ride over, so that's still there. So I did a bit of research and determined that the original counterweight was supposed to weigh about 45 pounds, and measuring on the mill, I determined that I could fit a piece of tube steel in there, about 2 inches by 5 inches, 12 inches long, capped off one end, and then I bought about 40 pounds of lead weight, took the whole thing outside, put it on a propane burner, and proceeded to melt the lead down into the tube. Now, this is part of the process that also happened, I think, about 2 years ago. I had actually created the counterweight, but then didn't do anything with it. So filled up the tube and then welded another cap on top of it, and that's where the project sat for about 2 years. So had to make the chain mounts yet. So I overcomplicated this part just a little bit. I figured the easiest way to start would be just to take some quarter-inch bolts and mill some flats on them so that I have a spot to hook the chain up. And that worked pretty well, got them all to shape, but it probably would have been better had I cut them to length on the bandsaw first. Then it was off to the sander to round over the edges so they'd be able to pivot properly when mounted to the chain. Then I moved on to creating the upper mounts for the chain. This was just some 1/8 inch material, 3/4 inch wide, that I cut to 1/2 inch and then drilled and tapped for the upper chain mounts. Now being only 1/8 inch thick, I had to grind off quite a bit of threads on the upper mounts. And then I went ahead and silver soldered the upper mounts in place. I had some welding spatter on the counterweight, so ground that off and then gave it a coat of red paint.